This OBS plugin is nothing new, so I want to make this video for both people who have been using it, but maybe not at its full potential, and also for people who have seen it and don't know how to do it. This plugin will allow you to move sources on your screen, whether they are triggered by a keyboard shortcut or transitioning from a scene to another. I would like to showcase two uses, one for your typical gaming live stream or video, and the other one for recording or live streaming some sort of video podcast. Here's where you can find it and how to install it. You can find it at obsproject.com. I will be leaving a link in the description. So when you get here, I advise you to actually go ahead and read all of this. There's not much, but it really explains how to install it and how to use it. Technically, you wouldn't even have to watch this video, but top right is where you're going to find the download button. And this brand new version 2.7.1 at the time of recording this video, it has been updated in November. So click download and make sure you pick your right operating system. In our case, it's going to be Windows. You can get the normal zip version, which you can install yourself, or you can get an installer, which will make the process easier. When it's done downloading, it will open here and you can double click on that installer file. So Windows Defender is going to have some issues. You can click on more and click run anyway. This is the part where you choose your install folder for OBS. I'm just going to check mine real quick to make sure that it's at the right location. So local disk C for me, it is. So I'm going to click next, then install. There you go. Finish. So just to make sure it will run smoothly, I'm going to restart OBS Studio because that's what I'm using to record this. Now we're back. One way to make sure that it's installed properly is to go into your scene transition panel, go down and see that we have add move, which means the installation was successful. Okay, so right before we jump into setting it up for our scenes and sources, I would like to take this time to thank our sponsor. And today's sponsor is Own Pro, a service that is made to work with OBS Studio. The goal here is to give you everything you need as a live streamer. Own Pro gives you access to the largest overlay pack library. And on top of that, those overlay packs are available in multiple languages. The overlay packs are one-click install, and Own Pro is compatible with Twitch, YouTube, and Facebook Gaming. If you already tried Own Pro and you're having issues with OBS 28, make sure you log into your dashboard and check out the instructions right here. And if you haven't tried it yet, make sure you check it out at own.gg/gallevelpro. That is own3d.gg/gallevelpro. Also, use code GALE to get 50% off at checkout. Okay, for the gaming setup, what I've done is I have set up a scene with my video capture device, my webcam basically, and underneath it, I'm gonna have a game capture, right? But it's hidden right now. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy those. So select both, right click, copy, and I'm gonna create a new scene with nothing. I'm gonna right click and I'm gonna paste reference, right? And now I'm gonna rearrange them in order to fit whatever I want them to fit, right? So I would want my camera to be in the corner, for example, and my game capture would be here. I can even crop it by holding Alt on my keyboard and dragging the sides. There you go. Let's go back to our first scene and I'm gonna go to scene transitions when it comes to my panels. I'm gonna click down the drop down and I'm gonna add move. Click okay. And something pretty important here is the properties, right? So the options under match if the source name is how it's going to detect which source is which, so that it can just move it from one place to another. In our case, we're gonna have the exact same name. So we're gonna match if the source name contains the other source name. Pretty simple. Underneath, we're gonna have options like with numbers removed from the end, matches the other source name. Basically, you could be like camera one, camera two, and it would still make the link between the two cameras. And match item, we're gonna find options such as ease. Here, like ease in and ease out is there by default. It's basically instead of going from one side to the other in a linear motion, it's gonna ease it out and then ease it in, meaning that it's gonna pick up speed to start and it's gonna slow down to end. Now, something kind of cool is transition scale type is how it's going to scale it to fit the other one. And it's great because from the page, we actually have an example of all the options, max only, aspect, and stretch. Stretch seems to be exactly what I'm looking for, so we're gonna pick that. You see it just stretches into the other one. So we're gonna pick that. Appearing items is basically sources that were not there in the first scene. And disappearing items is sources that will no longer be there in the next scene. Click okay, and let's see what it does when I switch to scene two. As you can see, it moves my camera to the side and reveals the gameplay underneath it. Now in this option, the gameplay is nowhere to be seen in the first scene. So technically we could delete it and see how that would affect the transition. If I go to game capture, press delete and delete it. And now I switch. You see the gameplay fly in because it's basically part of the appearing items now. So if I want to control it, I would have to control that specific option. Now the transition happens a little too fast for my liking. So what we're gonna do is go under our scenes transition tab, and right underneath it, we're gonna see duration. And I want this to be actually, let's say 2 seconds. It's gonna be kind of slow, but it's gonna look a little bit better. So if I click back to my first scene, you can really see what's happening here. I would like to have my game capture in the first scene so that it doesn't move. I don't want to see the black background, so I'm going to put it back in there. Paste reference. I just copy paste it and I'm going to put it underneath. So now only the camera seems to move. The other cool thing we can do is add the move transition as a filter, meaning that within the same scene, we can still make things move. In this case, let's say that the camera is here to the right and you would like to be bottom middle for some reason. I'm going to press Ctrl Z to put it back, and I'm going to right click on it, click filters, and we're going to click plus. And we're going to see we have a bunch of new move filters. We have move action, move source, move value, move video capture device, move transition override. All right, so if OBS suddenly looks slightly different, it's because I was forced to update it in the middle of recording this. So I'm very sorry. Everything is exactly where it was before. But now we're on OBS 28 and we're not going to have any issues. So back to what we were doing. We want to add the transition as, well, the move plugin. We want to add it as a filter for specific sources that we want to move within a same scene. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click on the scene 2. That is the scene we're on right now. I'm going to click on filters. I'm going to click on plus, and I'm going to click on move source. From there, we can pick a source that we want to move. All right. So we're going to put it on the side so we can see what we're doing. Under source, we're going to pick video capture device. That's the name of my webcam. Custom duration, we can set it to 1000. That's 1 second. And then we're going to find transform. Transform is what we need to tell the source where to go or what to do. For example, if I really wanted it to be middle, I can click here. I can drag it to the middle down there. I can even scale it down a little bit, right? So now it's gonna be middle, and I'm gonna click get transform. So it's gonna basically register the position and scale and cropping of that source. Now I can go back and put it here. Of course, you could add another filter to make sure that you can just make it go back. And if I scroll down, technically there isn't much to change here. Just click start. It should move it in 1 second to that position. There you go. Again, we don't have another thing to put it exactly where it was, but we could just add that. Let's click plus, move source two, pick the source, video capture device, and let's place it where we want it to be. Set a custom duration. Let's say we want it to take 2 seconds to go back now, and then get transform, because that's the position we wanted to get back to. All right, so let's go to the first move source, make it move down there. Nice, and let's go to the second one, make it move back. And something's wrong. Let's try again. Okay. And now. Okay, there we go. I think I clicked a little too fast. It wasn't done. And it just goes back to where it was. Now there's multiple ways to trigger this. For example, you can add a filter that is a move action, I believe. You can pick which source you want it to affect. Video capture device, and you can pick hotkeys that are already there. If you have a hotkey to mute that source, basically it can trigger it while you mute it. Unmute, push to talk, and all that stuff. What we can also do is add a specific hotkey for that specific source. So we're gonna close this, we're gonna go to settings, and we're gonna find our hotkeys. When we scroll down to scene 2, which is where we were, we're gonna see move source and move source 2. And here we can add any hotkeys that we want. Just click once and then put something like Control Shift F6. I said that in French, F6, and then Control Shift F7 or F7 in French. Click apply, click OK, and now I can press them to activate them. There you go, with hotkeys. And then I can just bring it back. Now for the fancy people who own a Stream Deck or a Stream Deck Plus, you can go under OBS and you can click on filter. Just drag and drop that. We're going to pick our scene, for example, or whatever source has the filter. Click on scene 2 in our case. Click on filter and we're going to have move source. Let's add another one so that we can bring it back. Scene 2, move source 2. And now I can just press and it moves. As you can see, So one thing I always wanted to try is to actually make it rotate, because I don't see a lot of people do that. So let me bring it back to the middle, and I actually want this position. Right click on the scene, go to filters. I believe that is the first one. I can delete the move action because we ended up not using it at all. And I can either directly go to rotation here and input 360, or I can right click on here, transform, rotate it, or click edit transform, and then input 360 here. If you didn't know, you can actually rotate sources on in OBS, like whatever degrees you want. But let's try this manually. 360 here, and now let's go to source 2 and see if it's gonna rotate. Okay, it did not rotate. Let's try that again. So it rotated coming back. There you go. So you can really see what type of movement it actually does between the values. The curve here is something that you can adjust so it plays with the easy ease and all of that. So the possibilities are obviously endless. I'll let you play around with that, but I think that's pretty cool that we can get this to move the way it does. Keeping in mind that you can do this with any type of source, and since it uses keyboard shortcuts, if you're a StreamerBot user, for example, you can make that a channel point redemption where your chat can actually control said source and place it wherever they want. All right, so this is the conversation recording, live streaming, video podcasting setup that I'm talking about. I'm basically using my phone as the caller. And then we're gonna have my camera here as me, the host. We are on Discord. I'm in a video call. It's gonna be full screen, basically. We're gonna keep it that way. And if you click once, it's gonna put it like that. So you can capture both screens. Actually, I ended up putting it in landscape mode because I think it's gonna be better. And I don't wanna go too much into detail on how to have like a setup like that, because I made a full video just explaining how to record the video podcast through Discord. All right, so let's get it started, and we're gonna create two scenes, same thing, or three scenes, and we're gonna set it up together. So while you have it in full screen right now, you're gonna Alt Tab and find your OBS. It's right there. I already have two empty scenes created, so I'm gonna go ahead and click plus, and I'm gonna go Window Capture, and I can call this one Host. Press Enter, and the window we're gonna pick is, of course, Discord, right there. Nice. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna right click on it. I'm gonna copy it. I'm gonna right click again outside of it, and I'm gonna paste a duplicate because I want it to be different. That second one, I can right click, rename it, and this one is gonna be guest. So I'm gonna turn off guest for now. I'm gonna click on host, and I'm gonna hold alt to crop it. Crop that. That's nice. Now, if you want to have the host and the guest in separate scenes so that you can control everything easily, you can do that, but we're not gonna do that right now. We're just gonna put this aside for now, and we're gonna go to guest. We're gonna hold alt again, and this time I'm actually gonna crop a little closer here. It's not the ideal situation, but I just wanna show you that it's possible. If someone's on mobile, you can still do this with them. Holding alt to crop. There we go. Dragging the sides. I'm gonna right click here. I'm gonna go to transform, and I'm gonna rotate 90 degrees clockwise, CW. There you go. And I can scale it in order for it to match the way I want. Nice, not bad. Now I can place them and use the arrow keys to move them about. And technically that could be, you know, your video thing. You can put the host here if you prefer, and the guest that way. Keep a little margin. And this is like very like Discord, very basic. But to make it look a little better, what we can do is actually scale this up way more. Same thing here. Just like that. We can adjust the cropping a little bit better. All right, that's nice. You can do all sorts of things with the transform, right click, transform. We're gonna flip it. Flip it horizontal. Nope, not horizontal. Not horizontal. We're gonna flip it vertical and reflip it horizontal. There you go. Nice. And I'm gonna place my head pretty much where I want it to be on the screen. And now I'm gonna crop this side right there. Good like that. It's nice. And we're gonna click on host. Crop it like that and keep a little margin in between them. There you go. So now it's kind of hard, but basically you would have, you know, a proper panel. This is what it would look like. I would probably go out of my way to properly crop everything to give the right margins. But what we can do now is select both of those, right click, copy. We're gonna go to scene 2. We're gonna right click and we can paste reference, and we can paste reference or duplicate because we can make the names match and the transition will still work. In this case, I'm gonna go duplicate just in case I really wanna modify them, add filters and all that. As you can see, we have the same scene, but now we can do whatever we want with it. It automatically renamed them guest 2 and host 2, but you can rename them if you want to just guest and host, but it doesn't matter because the move transition plugin takes it into account. So let's say that in this scene, I want the host to be full screen. What I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna move this to the side until it's out of frame, right? And now I'm gonna pick my host and I'm gonna uncrop all of this. Nice. Oops, not too much. And let's place this in the center-ish, like that, okay? Let's create a new scene. And you kind of get where I'm going with this, right? In this case, the host is gonna be pushed aside. And our guest is the one who's gonna be highlighted. Just like that. So I'm gonna go back to scene 1. This is what we have. And we're gonna click on the plus and we're gonna add a move transition right there. Boom, move. We're gonna click OK. And then we're gonna click contains the other source name for a match if the source name contains the other source name, right? We're gonna make sure all the options look good. We're gonna click OK and we're gonna set the duration, let's say 200 milliseconds. And we're gonna click on scene 2. Oh, this one stopped working. We're gonna click on scene 2 to see what it does. There you go. Now the host is highlighted. And I don't know why it did that. Let me go back. So scene 1 and scene 2 works perfectly, but the transition between scene 2 and scene 3 seems to be having issues. Instead of moving the opposite side, it just complete transitions out, which is fine because we can actually override the transition for those. We can right click on a scene, we can click transition override, and then we can add a new move transition. Now, in order to customize that one, we'd have to go and select it here and then go to options, properties, basically. Now we need to find out what the problem was. And I'm guessing it's with numbers removed from the end matching the other source name. We can tick both of those, click OK and see what it does. And it does exactly what we wanted to do. Is this one still, oh, this one's a little fast, but if we go back, what would it look like? There you go. And now you have both of them. So when you're doing the transition override, you can also set the actual timing. So remember that. There you go. And now everything should be working completely fine. Oh, I clicked a little too fast there. That's why. So it's not, so as you can see, you can break it if you're messing around with it a little too much. Also, I really love my transitions to be very, very slow. So that's why like I tend to click on stuff before the transition is completely done. So here I'm gonna right click and then transition override to the first one. This should do it. Smooth like butter. And that's how you can host your own video podcast, basically record it, live stream it, and do some cool stuff. Keep in mind that if you're using any widgets, anything, for example, to bring like a chat, like a question from chat or something like that, you can also make all of that move in gracefully into the scene and look great. Once again, I have a full video on how to set it up initially, including creating overlays to make everything look more customized. Once you're done with that video, you can do all the move transition stuff. Now, if you would like me to cover more OBS plugins, just let me know in the comment section. I will try to come up with some examples that you can use them for. In the meantime, go ahead and check out that video that I told you about setting up a live video podcast or just recording a video podcast using OBS Studio and a couple of free software in order to make it look very customized and very good. But in the meantime, thank you so, so much for watching this video. I will see you later. Go out there, make me proud, get a level, out.